Hello and welcome to Worldview at the Hindu with me, Suhasini Heather. This week, India's surging coronavirus cases take the sheen off the government's COVID diplomacy. We will look at the pros and the cons of this diplomacy.
New challenges, the really big one is getting enough raw materials which are being hoarded globally. We don't want to be in a situation that we ramp up in 2 months, as you mentioned, and then we're running short of raw materials.
You know, today, as foreign minister, I am pushing other countries, particularly some big countries, saying, look, please keep the raw materials flowing for vaccines to be made in India.
With more than 3 lakh cases, new cases every day, India is the country with the biggest surge at present. But over the past year, it has also been the country with the biggest heart, lifting its ban on the exports of drugs like HCQ when there was demand for it in 2020, sending medical teams to countries in the neighborhood and beyond, and then for its massive Vaccine Maitri program or Vaccine Friendship program, under which India exported more than 66 million doses of COVID vaccines to 95 countries worldwide. Of these, about 10 million were grants from the government to other governments, 20 million were sent as part of the global COVAX facility funded by the international agencies, and the rest, 36 million, were commercial exports. Few other countries have done as much. China, for example, exported 80 million doses to about 60 countries, but only after it had countered the pandemic inside the country. The European Union has exported more than 110 million doses to about 43 countries, but then the European Union does comprise 27 countries. In early April, India declared it was the fastest country in the world to give more than 100 million jabs to its own citizens. It achieved that feat in 85 days. The US took 89 days, China took 102 days, according to Health Ministry figures. India is also proud of being at the forefront of multilateral diplomacy efforts, including the Quad plan for 1 billion vaccine doses to be produced and then offered to Southeast Asian countries, and the India-South Africa effort. This is at the WTO. They are backed by other countries at the World Trade Organization to have all vaccine patents or TRIPS waived for the duration of the coronavirus pandemic. Finally, India, which is the second worst affected country by coronavirus today, says its efforts are in contrast to the worst affected country, and that is the United States. The US, through executive orders, through the use of its Defense Production Act, have made domestic production, the use of COVID vaccines and pharma supplies for its citizens only, for Americans only, it has made that its priority. And that is something India is hoping it will change. But speaking at the Raisina dialogue, Prime Minister Modi made this point subtly. He said India has walked the talk on helping global efforts, unlike some other countries. So why is it that the government is now facing this criticism over its diplomacy, very specifically? We're going to take a look at why this criticism to begin with. The first is for not anticipating the current crisis, the second wave as it's being called, and sending out the wrong message internationally that India was okay, that India did not need help. Remember, on January 29th, in his speech at the Davos Forum, Prime Minister Modi announced that the country had won the war against COVID. He repeated that in a message to Parliament a week later. India won acclaim from around the world for this. And at that time, India was seeing about 11,000 new cases a day and 1.5 lakh active cases. Today, that number has grown to 3 lakh new cases a day and 24 lakh active cases in an upward trend. The second reason for the criticism is the obvious lack of preparation and planning that can be seen from the parallel planning of international visits. India not only planned, the MEA not only planned its annual Raisina Dialogue Conference, it had made preparations for visits from India by the Rwandan president, the Danish prime minister, UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson was due to come to India, Japanese Prime Minister Suga as well, all of which had to be cancelled within days of those visits. Prime Minister Modi, in terms of the outward visits, did travel to Bangladesh along with his campaign travel around the country in March. He even had visits planned to Portugal for the EU-India leaders meeting, as well as France in the first week of May. All of these had to be cancelled. Every one of these visits had to be cancelled with days to spare, which shows that there was a lack of anticipation there. The third bit of criticism is that India did not use the time in the lull before this second wave of the coronavirus to leverage its strengths, to ramp up hospital bed strength, pharma supplies, oxygen production, to ask for imports where it was necessary, and for not halting the exports of things like pharma and oxygen that are now being needed the most. But lastly, and perhaps this is the one you've heard the most, is the criticism over the vaccine Maitri program that began at exactly the same time as the domestic vaccination program in India. The government is under criticism for sending vaccines further away than just the immediate South Asian neighborhood, because of course the case can be made that every South Asian country must be protected so that they don't spill back over into India. But then there were the vaccine exports to countries much further away. A majority of these were shipped out through February, through March. The last shipments actually headed abroad, according to the MEA website, on April 16th, just a week ago, which went to Albania and to Syria, which India exported more than 66 million doses of COVID vaccines to 95 countries worldwide. While India's entire vaccination program in India from mid-January to mid-April has meant about 130 million doses have been given to people. Some have got their first dose, some have also got their second dose, but it's 130 million doses in all. This means that at the very least, India exported what could have been used for an entire month of vaccinations domestically. What this also means is that as the government has declared vaccines for all over 18 years, open from May the 1st, that India has gone from being a proud exporter of vaccines to becoming one who needs and is encouraging imports of the vaccine, including the Russian Sputnik vaccine, US-developed Johnson & Johnson, Moderna, and Pfizer. France and Russia have now rushed in offers to help, and very specifically, Russia is offering oxygen as well as remdesivir stocks to India. Now, in the face of all this criticism, the government's defense, and it was expressed by External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar, is simple. India cannot ask the world for help for vaccine supplies if it is not willing to export its own product to help others. The answer or the counter to that might well be that India is the world's second most populous country itself. After the US, it has the highest number of cases, the highest number of new cases, active cases, as well as deaths. If it helps its own citizens, it will take a large load off the global pandemic worry and do its bit towards fighting the coronavirus. Now, there are several articles on our website, www.thehindu.com, including a column by former diplomat Vivek Kadju, discussing the cons of vaccine diplomacy. There is a counter to that. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar has written an article in the Newsweek, Reimagining Diplomacy in the Post-COVID World, an Indian Perspective. There's also a book that's just out called Preventing the Next Pandemic, Vaccine Diplomacy in a Time of Anti-Science by Peter Hotez. Remember, this debate will continue and we will keep tracking it for you. But from the team here at Worldview, for the moment, thanks for watching.